That ain't fixing to get started yet, is it?
No. Okay. Just in case we got fire, but it won't kick weapons up.
Yeah. All right. Well, that's good.
Celebration, honoring of those who, from this county, who fought, and those who gave the ultimate sacrifice. Good morning, Southerners, fellow Southerners, and we'll start it off with a word of prayer. Let us pray. Most precious Heavenly Father, we come to you humbly today, honoring your name, Lord. Wishing to honor those who came before us, those who fought for liberty and paid the ultimate sacrifice on the altar of their country. Lord, let us never forget their sacrifice, and Lord, let our children and their children and on down the ages continue to honor this sacrifice, because it's our family, Lord. Let us always remember our family. Fought and who made the ultimate sacrifice. We praise you for this day. We praise you for this wonderful, beautiful sunshine. And Lord, be with us as we honor our folks. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
First thing we want to do is we'll have our lovely ladies place a wreath and honor in the center to honor all those who fought and especially those who made the ultimate sacrifice, who didn't come to center while they didn't come home. Last year at this, I saw Angel go over and put her hand on the wall. And I knew this is a personal connection for her. There's nothing better than to hear somebody, a real testimony from somebody that it matters to. And number two, it's their folks. So without further words, Angel, if you would, tell us about your folks.
Okay. On the first wall, there are three names: Obadiah Hester, Christopher C. Hester, and Simpson Hester. Christopher is my four times great-grandfather. His son Simpson is right after him on the wall. His nephew Obadiah is right before him on the wall. They enlisted in the 2nd Cavalry. Christopher's brother Charles Hester also enlisted, but he enlisted in St. Clair County in the 31st Alabama, so he is not on the wall. Christopher also fought in the Indian Wars in Florida, so he was already 49 years old when the Civil War broke out. So he was an old man by that time, because you know, life expectancy back then wasn't very much longer. So they put him as a commissary for the second cab. When his family moved here, they created a church, one of the oldest churches in Calhoun County. His name is on the cornerstone as the first deacon of that church. One of his granddaughters eventually became one of the pastor's wives of that church. So CC got to see his family grow, and he done really well. He prospered, had lots of land, and then his brother Charles, that was in the 31st, I don't know very much about him, but remember his name. On this wall, I have another four times great-grandfather, Warren Powell. He was in age as well, so he went to the camp of instruction in Talladega, and that's where he was at in the Hardee's Guard Reserves, which is pretty awesome. Just above him on the wall is N.J. or Jacob Powell, his son, his youngest son. I don't know very much about him except for that he was in the 44th Alabama. And I can't find him on any census records, so I don't know where he went after the war. On the center wall, I have Warren's brother, or son, his oldest son, Patterson Powell. He was with the 51st Partisan Rangers. After they disbanded, he went to the 2nd Infantry. I know that his unit was at Chilo, at Chattanooga, and Chickamauga, but I don't know where he died at. So that's very moving to me that one of mine gave his life for this. So that's why we reference the wall and what we do because of keeping his memory alive. Now back to Charles Hester in the 31st. He is on my father's side. Now on my mother's father's side, I have a James Nelson that was also with the 31st. And then on my mother's side, I have another one that was also in the 31st. So did my grandfathers from two different sides share food? Did one of them save the other's life? You know, were they best buds? It's very interesting to know that four generations later, I'm connected to two soldiers that might have shared a team. Very cool. And where would I be if one of them hadn't saved the other's life? You know, I had two grandfathers and an uncle that were right there close together. And that's very cool because not only as us as reenactors a family, but they were family and didn't even know it. So that's very cool that our lives are still connected four generations later. And four generations from now, are our lives going to be connected? You know, Terry, one of your sons going to marry one of my granddaughters four generations later. That's very cool to think that. So no matter our opinions or our feelings or what we think about each other, we're still a family. Just like these guys were. We're all family. So remember that when you're on the battlefield, that's my brother. And that's my sister. Because one day we could all be connected.
That has been my exact experience through genealogy, is knowing that lots of my folks and lots of the people who I reenact with, folks rub shoulders together in the Confederate Army. And one other thing I like to point out is this man came home and he was a pillar of his church. And that's the story of most Southerners. They came home determined to make the world as good as they could and do it through church. I want to praise them for that. But right now we're going to fire a salute to the fallen and those who did come home. So if you would, brother, take care of them.
Shoulder.
In this today. It means a lot to these fellas that run this and own this. It means a lot to them. Of course, it means a lot to us, and it really should. But I want to thank each one of you personally for coming to this. I want to close this up with a word of prayer. Let us pray. Most precious Heavenly Father, we again come to you, praising you for this day, praising you for your Son, who is our only way to heaven. We praise you for your master plan. Lord, we ask that these men who are immortalized on this wall would be remembered by the world for what they really were, heroes and patriots. Lord, defeat those whose aim is to mock our history. Lord, give us the strength to, first of all, proclaim your name wherever we go, but always to proclaim our ancestors and their goodness. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Thank every one of you again. Thank y'all for coming. Hey, if you
George James, three cheers.
Three cheers for Angel. Hip hip
hooray!
Hip hip
hooray!
Hip hip
hooray!
All right, thank y'all. Thank you so much.
Golly, yes, you did great.
Great.
You did good.
Yeah.
Awesome.
That
was a nice
awesome.
Presentation.
Yeah, it was.
It would be real.
Yes.
Think about
it. Thanks for coming.
You would think with my unique last name that I could find it.
Ha 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 ha!
that's right.
Georgia! Georgia!
Thank you.